All right. Gonna move her away. And then where? All right. So the gladiator takes you across past the temple, down the stairs, around the merchant ward, down this way, across, up, and over here. So as you kind of walk out this, you walk out these city gates, and you see that there's a giant portcullis and things that you would expect, like as if they were trying to like hold off an army, like that level of security at the door. As you come out this way, you also see that there are these giant ziggurats, which kind of like look like they're old Aztecian kind of like pyramid kind of things. You see that there's shops and tenements of bamboo, and they're just like, it's as if you kind of walked into the commoners crowd. There's just a bunch of people wall to wall, shoulder to shoulder here. And as you walk out, you see kind of like this large depression in the ground where there are a bunch of people that are kind of crowding around it. And you hear screams and roars and cheers and other things like that. And as you approach closer, you see that the crowd seems to split apart as the gladiator gets close. And as they do, you get a clear vision of kind of like this large pit. And you happen to be on the end that it kind of, where it starts to delve into the pit. And you see that there are these knotted ropes that are at your feet. And down below, you see that there are these giant different dinosaurs and velociraptors and Allosaurus and all that. And on the way far end, you see that there is a just one sole figure down in the depths. And on the side, you see that there's an announcer, and it says, welcome, welcome to the midday. Sorry, hold on. To the midday executioner's run. And the crowd's just like, and it says, yes, today we have another thief who has been relegated to this gauntlet. If he can surpass the monsters and beasts down there, he will have his freedom. And so from the looks of it, it seems like basically the gauntlet is just trying to get through a number of dinosaurs. And judging by the number of dinosaurs that are in the pit right now, you would imagine that this guy was trying to pull off something huge.
And the priest, the woman still with us?
Nope. She did not come.
I'm going to ask the gladiator, get out of this.
So he says, do not let the announcer's words fool you. This used to be the pit for a competitive ball game, but now it is used for entertainment. We punish those who decide to break the law. And then there are also those that are trying to claim glory. All you have to do is make it from that end to this end. Climb up these ropes, and you are free. And if you're doing it for glory, glory is set upon you. And if you're doing it for your freedom, well, Not many people make it for freedom.
Has one person made it for freedom?
Oh, a few over the course of the years. But this old man here, he certainly won't make it. And you look over, and Omal is definitely not. He is not having it. He is not having a good day.
I go with a smirk on my face. I turn around and try and find the lady that we were just talking to.
So she stayed in the Golden Throne room.
Okay. So I go back to the Golden Throne room.
How healthy does Omal look?
Healthy, but he's got to be in his 60s.
Okay, so it's not like he's gonna keel over any moment. He's just like he's healthy and for his age and whatnot. So
yes, he's a master craftsman or a master at his craft. He's just older.
He's not sickly.
Not sickly. No.
Yeah, that's all I'm wondering there.
Gotcha.
Being a grave cleric.
Right. Yes, of course. Let's see. As this conversation is happening, that guy inside gets torn apart. like utterly and easily, let's say.
Ooh.
And the crowd goes wild, and you know everything is like, "Ooh, doesn't look like he is going to be getting up in the morning." Obviously, this is very, very crass, very, very inappropriate if you come from a civilization that is not this. But apparently, this is just the way that things are here.
No.
As you turn to walk away, Shagarath. What happens is the velociraptors start they look like they're in a bloodthirst, and they look at the edge of the ring, and they start kind of scrambling up the walls, and the announcer says, "Oh, looks like we're getting an escapee. Everybody better run." Ha ha. And obviously this puts everyone in panic. There's pandemonium. Everybody's running everywhere. And there are people that are being attacked by these velociraptors. There are four, to be exact.
Well, I cannot stand for that. It's not the right time for them to die.
All right. Well, if that is the case... I'm gonna put you guys, let's see here. Omal is sad. I'm gonna put you all here. Went. And I'm using the formation sheet thing as our makeshift. And then I need to give you guys some opponents, huh? Let's go with one, two, three velociraptors.
Them.
Wait, I said four, didn't I?
You did.
Four velociraptors. Whip, and there you go. All right. Who's stepping in?
I guess I will. Yeah.
You want us to move us somewhere?
I'm going to leave you guys where you're at. You can start from there.
Okay. Do you want us to do an initiative or?
Oh, that would be lovely. Please, initiative check.
cleric.
So good. So good.
Every time.
It gets me every time.
Oh, I should have really been on that spell.
So initiative's going to be on your main page in the middle.
Intelligence.
INT. I was close.
It's true.
All right. We're waiting on for Lawson. There he is. All right. Ayer, you are the first to move.
Okay.
So, as a reiteration, you get one action, one bonus action, one reaction, and one movement action per round.
I'm going to cast Hunter's Mark on the front, the closest Velociraptor.
Okay.
And I will attack it. I will shoot it.
Okay. Let me figure out which Velociraptor that is.
So, oh, I just realized I was muted. Sorry.
Wow. All right, sorry. So that's Velociraptor 2 that you are Hunter's Mark.
Two, Hunter's Mark on Velociraptor.
Yeah, if you want to drop that on there.
Is it how to do that?
You're good.
Let's see. Ire.
Boom.
There you go. Nice. Go ahead and make your attack roll.
Let's see. Okay. My bonus only. Grab that dice.
All right, a 16. Hits the Velociraptor. So go ahead and roll your damage.
Is it just, for damage, it's just dex modifier, right?
It'll be 1d8 plus 3 piercing.
But then, like, my Hunter's Mark and then my favorite roll enemy. There's a lot of stuff going on. I have plus 2 to damage on beasts, on dinosaurs.
Alright, perfect. So that is a lot of health that you basically one-shot that guy. Yep. Nice. Good work.
Captain Chuck.
Okay.
As a bonus action, move my Hunter's Mark to Velociraptor 4, since Velociraptor 2 is dead.
All right, go ahead and do that. And would you like to move? Or are you staying in one place?
Oh, and then I...
Oh. Okay, perfect. All right. This Velociraptor is going to go... Let's see. It's going to move away from the commoner. It's going to go... 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Right in range of... Shava.
No.
Damn it.
Sorry. And so this Velociraptor is going to make a swipe at you with
Great.
Their claws. How's a 7 treat you?
I don't know what that
She's
means.
Fine.
So if you check your character sheet on the main screen,
yeah.
You'll see that you have an AC.
Yeah.
And so your AC is 13?
Yep.
So if someone's rolling against you, if they do not match or exceed your AC, then you are able to deflect their attack, you're able to dodge their attack, you're able to whatever
you want. That's
pleasant. So the unfortunate thing about these animals is that they attack twice.
Oh, good.
Oh.
So it tries to bite you with a 15.
Great.
If I remember correctly, a 15... will hit you.
Yeah.
So you will take 3 points of damage.
Good.
All right, another one. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30 for Lawson. Going to claw at you. And it had a crit.
I don't like that.
So it's going to do its crit damage here. So with its crit, it does a 5 damage to you.
5 damage.
5 damage. That is, that means you're down to 75%, just in case, math wise.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to try to bite you. And that's a 19. And I believe that's also above your AC.
Yep.
And that's another 5 damage.
Sweet. Yeah, I was just thinking Shaba was taking a lot of damage.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Oh, sad. Sad velociraptors.
We'll have to wait.
Shio, what's up?
So which one is attacked? Which velociraptors have attacked so far?
These are all fresh. One of them has a hunter's mark on them, but I don't think that affects you. Does it only affect you, Ire?
Let me check. Yeah, it's just me, and then like for tracking it. I don't think anyone else gets the bonus.
Sweet, Shio.
And it's on number C. Yeah, it's on C. So as a bonus action, I'm going to cast Hexblade's Curse on Velociraptor number 1.
Okay.
So
all right.
And then I will cast a Crown of Madness on number, is that number 3?
Sure. All right. Okay. Actually, you can't.
I can't?
No. Crown of Madness is used on one humanoid of your choice. A velociraptor is not a humanoid. Damn.
That sucks. Okay. Then I'll just cast Eldritch Blast on velociraptor number 1.
Okay.
Cast it on 4. Okay. It doesn't matter.
Okay. So, I gotta make sure I'm rolling enough dice here.
So you make a ranged spell attack.
Yeah, hold on.
Which, if you, check your actions there. If you just click on cast. Yep, you hit it.
Okay. And then damage, because one of my invocations is the enhanced one, I deal 2 die instead of 1.
Okay. And then it would also do the cursed effect, which is irrelevant at this point in time, yeah? Because you killed it.
Yeah.
All right. Cool. Anything else there, Shio?
Just trying to make sure it doesn't do anything. No, because it's higher levels that it gets to bounce to my to a new target. So
yeah,
goes again. Good. I hear pause bleeding.
What?
Look at the towel.
Oh no, I don't know what the
Sapphire.
Oh. All right, I am going to move up to here.
Okay.
And do attack Velociraptor 4.
Okay. You rolled a 12. Velociraptor 4 has an AC that is above that. You hit him, but he does not seem to be affected by that attack, that blow.
That's all that I'm going to do.
Okay. Verlassen.
Yeah.
You're hurting there, buddy.
I am hurting there. I don't think I have any healing abilities. So, I think I'll do my breath weapon. Like, I'll move. I don't... Enough space is a way to still do damage to at least... They're clumped together, right?
Yep.
Will I damage anybody? Will I damage Sapphire there if I attack the two of them there?
Yep. He will at least have to make the save on it. Yes.
What if I just attack the one in front of me?
You could certainly do that.
I'll just do that.
Okay.
And so I just do that guy, right?
All right. So with that, he's got to make a... I think that's a dexterity check, yeah?
Breath weapon. Charisma.
No, he uses his charisma for the modifier. Actually, it should be constitution.
You told me charisma.
Huh? What?
It's constitution.
I remember you were talking about that, and you said charisma for that.
For breath weapon?
Should be constitution. Yeah, pretty sure.
It shouldn't just, like, for the person being attacked.
Sorry. So, to determine the spell save DC.
Oh, that side of.
It should be your constitution modifier plus your proficiency.
Oh, you're right, yeah.
So, let's see here. Which it is. Okay, so that's fine. Okay. And the person has to make a DC throw. I think it's Dex, yeah?
It's a fire.
Each creature of the area exhalation makes a saving throw, the type of which is determined by your draconic ancestry. Ah, okay. So yes, yeah. It's fire, which means it's what? I don't know.
Dex.
It is Dex. Awesome. Yeah. Thanks. Velociraptor 4 doing that Dex check. Oh, he's nimble. Oh, he dodged out of the way. Oh, that's unfortunate.
Takes half damage.
All right.
How can my cone miss him?
Well, half. You do half damage. He's able to miss.
Oh, okay.
So, I believe that's 2d6 for the fire. Yeah. Let's see.
Sure.
Your breath weapon. The damage is 2d6. So roll 2d6 and I'll take half. And we round down in Dungeons and Dragons land, so that's a hearty one damage there, buddy. I don't think you have a bonus action. What?
Why didn't I go to work today and just skip this?
Would you like to move around or would you like to stay?
I'd like to run.
He's gonna get an opportunity attack.
If you,
it's okay. If he goes down, my healing is better.
Yeah, because you're grave domain.
Sorry, were you being serious or were you being jokingly?
Can I get behind somebody else? Like away from them.
So, at the moment, if you try to move away from him, he will have an attack of opportunity on you, which means that he gets to attack you for free. So it might be better
to stay put
and allow the rest of your team to try to clear them out, because there's still three other people after you.
Good idea.
Okay. Crow.
So before I do anything, there was that tracker we used before, so that way I could actually like put my attacks against certain targets. I don't have that up.
I think if it's a specific thing, you can drag and drop it
onto the
tokens onto the combat tracker. Yeah,
that's what I did.
Oh, are you looking for the combat tracker? Yeah, that's the cross swords top right.
Okay, thank you. Okay.
Oh, that's why people were wondering which one was damaged. Yeah, if you touch the cross swords in the top right, it'll show you what creatures have been hit and how much damage they've taken, showing you generally. I don't want to give you all the information, you know?
No, don't give us all the information. Let's lay...
I feel actually so gonna go alive. Ahead
and I want... So I want charisma saving throws for the bum. As I am going to go ahead and cast Bane on them.
Okay, charisma saving throws on both of them?
Yes.
All right. Do. Velociraptor number 3.
Mark off that spell slot right away.
Rolled an 8.
Well, that's a fail.
Velociraptor number 4 rolled a 3.
Cool. How do I drag the effect onto them? Oh, okay. I got it. Bam.
All right. So it looks like they are. So what's the spell effect? Do you mind just describing that for me?
Yeah. So Bane, what that does is after I can choose up to 3 creatures. Whenever if they fail, whenever they make attack roll or saving throw, before the spell ends, they have to roll a d4 and subtract that number rolled from the attack roll or saving roll. Throw.
Gotcha.
So if they rolled, yeah. So just, you know, makes them a little bit less effective.
Gotcha. All right, sweet. Who's up?
Yeah.
That is Shava.
Okay, so I'm gonna move adjacent to Velociraptor 3.
Okay.
Do I just do that? Yeah, okay.
So, by doing that, so you are here, right?
Yeah.
So each Velociraptor has a reach of 5 feet, which means all 8 squares around them are their space. So if you move outside of that space for any reason, they can make an attack of opportunity.
Fuck. Okay, so then so Velociraptor 4, is that within range of a melee attack?
Yes.
Like, am I considered adjacent? Okay, then I'm just going to attack that one, sorry.
No, it's okay.
I'm going to do the Flame Blade spell attack on Velociraptor 4.
All right. 17 hits. Yeah, that'll do it. So with the 14 damage there, you are able to kill that one off easily.
Yay.
Alright. Ayer?
My hero.
As a bonus action, I want to move my hunter's mark onto the last Velociraptor.
Okay.
Round. It can do it for an hour.
Yeah, we can do it on this new round. Because you used your bonus action on the last round already.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to kind of step to the side here so I don't have to shoot through my party.
That won't be a big problem, right?
Oh yeah, we were doing the crits.
And let's start. Damn it. I miss.
You sound sad by that.
I mean, I missed, right?
Yeah. Yeah, you did. unfortunately. I'm sorry that that's the case. All right. So Velociraptor number 3, feeling outnumbered at this point in time, lets out a weird kind of screeching cry, and after he does that, there is a return screeching cry, which is problematic, and the announcer says, "Oh no! He called for his brothers! Hopefully these heroes can take them on!"
That announcer?
Yeah.
The announcer's still gone.
He's still. So, from one of the tents off to the left, you see a couple of commoners run away. He's like, "They're out of control!" And these two... You would say velociraptors, but they certainly look a little bit bigger than this one and a little bit meaner than this one. Pop out, and they kind of like are looking around for where the cry came from. Let me just put
them. Raptors.
Right. And right.
Oh,
these guys look very much meaner. These ones. Let me give it the
all right.
Two.
When?
Two.
We'll be fine.
And for funsies, it's going to give you a tickle there, Sapphire. With his claws. Even with the Bane on him, he rolls an 18.
Oh!
And so that's 6 damage. Seth. Alright, Shio.
Alright.
Got a couple of new challengers approaching.
Okay. Do we need to roll another initiative? Or do they just...
Nope, they just are added in.
Alright, I'm going to draw... Is drawing Scheherazade an action, or is that just something I can do? Can't remember.
So I believe to that particular... In general, if you're drawing a weapon, that's a free action. But your particular weapon, I believe you have to use a bonus action to summon it.
Okay.
Let me double check here.
Yeah, I'm trying to like, make sure I have that right, and I can't.
So you've got the hex blade. You are a hex warrior. Allows you to mystically channel your will through a particular weapon. If you touch one weapon, blah blah blah, yada yada. And then you also have Pact of the Blade. You can use your action to create a Pact weapon in your empty hand. So, that would be a normal action.
Okay. I am still safe distance away, I think, right?
Yes.
Okay. So, I will... draw Scheherazade.
All right. Okay. Awesome.
And then move so that I'm just out of reach of any lunge from any of the dinosaurs.
Outside the reach of any lunge.
Any.
Do you know what lunging range is for these dinosaurs? You move yourself. You move yourself where you think you should be.
Where am I right now?
You're behind.
You're the bottom one. You're under Verlassen.
Hold on.
So if you can't see yourself, if you grab that yellow D-pad looking thing with the left click and you move it, you can move yourself around. Or you can try to expand it if you would like.
Okay, I'll just stay there. That's fine.
All right. And just so you know, or just for everybody else to know, what happened to Shio is that when he summons this weapon, there is kind of like a shadowy demonic transformation, and what appears in his hand is a whip, it looks like.
I didn't know you were a magical girl.
So you're going to be using D4 for your attacks there, Shio.
Got it.
Okay. You moved yourself? Or you didn't move yourself?
I just stayed put.
Okay, Saf.
Okay, I'm going to just attack the one that's in front of me.
Mm-hmm. Do it.
Have it again.
With gusto.
Hey.
Do you def hit? You definitely hit that one. Nine damage. It is in a critical state, but it is still standing.
I'd like to use a blade flourish.
Alright.
And then I will just roll. What's my inspiration's a 6 right now, yeah.
Fairly certain.
So an additional 2 damage to it. Alright,
with a slash, and then you come around with another attack that is swift, and you cut down your foe easily.
That flourish, I'm going to use the defensive flourish, so I gain an additional 2 to my AC for the round.
All right. Good to know. All right. So, seeing that that the one that called them just fell, these two, what they're going to do is this one's going to make a beeline for you. So that's 5, 10, 15, 20 feet. And then what it's going to do is it's going to pounce, which means it's going to head straight for a creature. And when it hits it with a claw on the same turn, the target must succeed on a DC save. So let's see if we hit. It missed completely and was not able to turn that into any purchase there. Tries to give you a little nibble. And it definitely did not do that. It made a critical miss. And nothing bad happens. Other one, though. 5, 10, 15, 20. And it's going to pounce on Shava.
The fuck off me.
Shava, you have a AC that's higher than 10, yeah?
Yeah, 13.
All right. So these both of these, I'm not going to try to... Dinonychus. they tried to charge in, and they were not able to do anything. This one tries to nibble you with 13.
So I minus 13, does that mean it got me or not?
So yes, the roller wins when it comes to that situation. So if there's ties, roller wins. You take a grand 3 damage there. For Lassen.
Yes.
How big is your thunderclap?
Let me double check. I was looking, it is 5 feet.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
Range 5 feet. Oh wait, sorry. It can be heard 100 feet.
Oh, it can be heard 100 feet. It is range 5 feet. Okay, never mind. Carry on.
How long is the rest period for my breath weapon? It didn't say specifically.
Yep, a day. Long rest. Or a short rest.
Long rest, okay.
Or a short rest, but you haven't done either.
Okay, so I would have to use that as a turn to short rest.
Short rest is an hour period of resting.
Okay.
Round is 6 seconds.
Okay.
There is a kind of neat spot right there in the middle, though. You can certainly hit them both there with your...
And then I'll also probably get killed.
Details.
I'm a gambling man. How do I move my person?
Do it.
There it is. Okay, moving right there. And I'm going to use my Thunderclap, which is probably going to injure everybody else around me, but whatever.
My God, Verlasa.
We could always move one more over.
Okay, oh. I guess.
No! Damn it! Damn it, Crow!
You don't have to be hitting the only injured people, too.
Yeah. I don't know if I should make this move. I guess it's too late now. Okay, I guess I'll do my Thunderclap.
Okay. So you...
And my 1d6.
So before you do that, I'm doing Constitution save and throws. So you slam your anvil. Do you want to describe that?
I take my hammer and I smash the ground.
Perfect. That one fails. And that one fails. They both fail their saves. Go ahead and roll damage for me, bro.
God.
Alright, 5 damages for both of them.
Wait. 5 damages.
Damages. Crow. Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Did you have anything else that you could do as a bonus action or a reaction there for Lassen?
I don't know if I have any bonus actions. I wasn't trying to find that.
I doubt that you do, just based on the fact that...
Okay.
Yeah, I don't think you do.
Okay.
All right. Crow.
All right. I'm gonna boop and then boop to here.
Verlassen, I completely forgot to make you roll on the magic table, the wild magic table, like a long ass time ago. We'll worry about that.
Oh
later.
Shit!
It's okay. Next time. Next time.
What would that have done? Give me lots of points or lots more damage and stuff?
It would have had a random effect of some kind. It was when you made the book really small. But it's okay. We won't retcon that.
No, we won't. It'll be fine.
First and foremost, I'm going to go second level healing word on Shava. Do I just drag and drop it onto Shava or?
Sure, go ahead.
See if that works.
Oh, why are you healing her of it? She has twice as much health as me.
Yeah, I have my own healing. Okay, thank you.
No problem. So, you're about to go down, which means that when you go down, my spells are better on you. So if I heal her, if she doesn't go down, I don't have to worry about that.
What are you saying?
What?
Well, if Verlassen goes to 0 HP and I cure wounds on him at second level, it will be max healing. Because he's unconscious and I'm a grave player. But if two people are like that, I can't do it for both.
Okay.
So that was my character's thinking. And then as an action.
Kill me. Yeah.
He stabs you so he can heal you. Sorry, go ahead, Crow.
As an action, I am going to go ahead and look at Dionyke's. And I'm going to say, to the grave with you. No save. I am packed to the graving it. It's my channel divinity.
Okay.
So the next attack that hits it, it is vulnerable to that damage.
Okay. Which means he takes double damage, I believe.
Correct. And that is my turn.
Okay. Shava.
I'm going to wait. Which one did you just target with that? Both of them?
The one that is no, just the one. Dynaki's one.
One? Oh, I can't reach that one. But it doesn't matter. It's just whatever the next attack is. It doesn't have to be. Oh, okay.
Yeah, it doesn't have to be the next turn. It's just whatever attack next hits it before.
Oh, cool. Okay, so then I'm gonna attack the one in front of me with my poison spray.
All right.
Sexy.
It's just a
con save.
Yeah.
Let's see where they at. Ooh, it's got a pretty high con. Is there any effect on a successful save, or is it just a?
No.
Okay, so you poof out some poison in his general direction, and he kind of just shakes it off. Doesn't seem to like breathe it in.
Well, that's irritating.
But he's making eyes at you, so there's that.
Yeah. Well. Oh.
Ire.
There's that.
As a bonus action, I will drop my Hunter's Mark on this one.
Okay.
To shoot it.
Oh,
ooh. That is a fail. All right, so I need you to roll another d20, please, sir. Just a 20. Random d20 there. Ooh, all right. So I've got this fancy dandy fumble table here for ranged attacks. Let me just roll on here.
Oh, God. So excited.
Sapphire.
Shoots Verlossum.
So I'm going to... Let's see. Here we go. So, did you see that? Your attack ricochets back and hits yourself. Apply the maximum non-critical damage to yourself as if you had hit your target. I'm going to ignore the curses
11.
and the hunter's mark that's on the
it's on him, not me.
Right. So 11 is the maximum damage that could be done to yourself. Or done with the bow, I guess, by itself.
Done with the bow by itself.
Does that make sense?
D8 plus 3.
Yeah. Great. So as you fire, instead of letting go of the notched arrow, you let go of the handle, and it kind of smacks you in the face there.
Oh!
When I do that.
All right.
I'm fine, guys. I'm fine.
Anything else?
No.
Shio.
It's gonna.
You've got your whip there.
I got the whip.
You got the whip.
I'll move whip. Next to Dino Nikus 2.
Electric <Blue. laughs>
And I'll attack with the whip.
All right, sweet. Go ahead and make that that roll, please. Do you want me to move you, or you got it? Sweet.
I got it. So it's a D. Sorry, I'm trying to figure out how I can use this because, like, I use my charisma instead of my dex.
I changed all of those, so if you double click it, it should just be fine. But if you want me to tell you, it's just a plus 3, so it'd be a D20 plus 3.
Okay. It's all good.
Ooh, a 10. I don't think so. Not on this day. Not at this time.
So, hit 13. Guys. Well, it's plus 3. Sorry, I rolled a regular die instead of using the attack.
Oh,
so
it'd be sorry. 13. Yeah, definitely. Definitely this day. Definitely this time. All right, so damage. That would be a D4 plus 1. There you go.
thing hits.
Sick. Sapphire. You are up.
Right.
Wait, did he say 13 hit?
13 to hit.
Oh. 13 to hit.
Oh. I'm go ahead and attack again.
Okay. Also, just for my sake, your defensive flourish ends when it's your turn again. Okay. Go ahead and attack, sir. An 11 is not enough to damage.
They're just doing the great rolls here. Great rolls.
Either.
Really, Ben?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, then, as a bonus action, I'm going to use I'm going to use healing word on really.
All right. And that's on who? Sorry, one more time. On whom, I guess?
To me.
To yourself?
Me.
Oh. Well, there you go. You're all healed up. Patched up. No problem. Okay. Dino's turns.
Owie.
Let's see.
Here we go.
Who hit them most recently? Verlassen. how's a 9 treat you, Verlassen?
Oh, that doesn't hit me. I have an 11.
Okay. And then Crow. He doesn't like you. He's gonna try to bite you.
Okay.
How's an 11 treat you?
That will miss.
Okay. It bites its thumb at you. How about that?
Alright. I'll take it.
The other one, let's see. Not too happy about Shava with her poison spray.
Yeah.
He's gonna hit with a 23, I believe.
Yeah.
He does 6 damage. Not too happy about Whip Boy over here either. How's a 13, Tricha?
It hits.
It hits. It does a solid 3 damage. Watch out, boys. It's coming for you.
I whip my hair back in.
Oh! I fucked up on that first. I fucked up on the other dino. This one makes 3 attacks. It's going to claw at Whip Boy. 13?
Yep, hits.
Another 3 damage. For Lawson.
Yay, so what's the deal with my wild magic thing?
So if you cast a first or second level spell, what happens is you roll a d20, and if you roll a 20, then you get to roll on this really big d100 table, I believe is how it works. Let's see.
Yeah.
If you immediately after you cast a first level or higher, DM rolls a d20. If you roll a 1, you get to roll on the table. So.
I get to what?
You get to roll on a d20 table. So basically, use a first level spell and we'll walk through it.
Or if you want to just trigger it.
Oh, can you?
Well, it's, you can, Wild Magic can do Tides of Chaos to get advantage. And then when they cast a spell as a DM, you can just choose when the Wild Magic Surge happens next time they cast a spell.
Oh.
So that's always a fun option.
Okay. Tides of Chaos. You can manipulate the forces of chance and chaos to give you advantage on an attack roll. Once you do so, you can have to finish a long rest. Then any time before you regain the use of that spell, the DM can have you roll on the Wild Magic Surge table immediately. After you cast your next spell. Okay.
Right. So I have to cast an enhanced ability spell now. Or can't a level 1 or level 2 spell, right?
Yeah. If you want to.
The only...
Yeah.
I can't use reduce again. Enlarge and reduce because I used it earlier.
Nope, you can. You've got a second level spell slot still.
Okay, so I'll do that and I'll reduce the one with the more health.
Okay. Let's see. It has to make a save, I would imagine. If the target is unwilling, it has to make a constitution saving throw. The one with more health. Cons throw. It saved. It did not get smaller. That's okay.
But I still get the wild card.
Oh, wait. You can do the Tides of Chaos, which means you get to roll again. Or, I guess, wait, how does that work?
I don't think you can Tides of Chaos somebody else's roll.
Yeah, that doesn't work. Okay. Alright, whatever. That's cool. Do you want to just roll on the table anyway?
Yeah.
Alright, so what I need you to do is pick up a D10, right-click it once so you have two D10. Wait, that's not how that works. Right-click it. Oh, right-click the D10, and then there's a percentage sign in the top left. Click that.
Yeah. Okay.
And then roll that.
I think I got the D10.
Four.
Oh, boy.
Okay.
Can I roll again?
No, you're fine.
It's okay. Oh, okay. I don't think it's the one.
Here it is. Wait.
Oh, goddammit. It's
not. Alright, let me, so you cast Confusion centered on yourself.
That's all of us.
Can I start acting like the...
This spell assaults and twists creatures' minds, spawning delusions and provoking uncontrolled actions. Each creature in a 10-foot by 10-foot radius sphere must succeed on a wisdom saving throw when you cast this spell, or they will be affected by it. So let's see here. A 10 by... It's not letting me draw. Oh, I know why. It's over here. Wait.
Everybody, except for me.
Yep.
All right. Well, here's my save.
18, you saved.
Yeah. What was the? What did it have to be?
12, I think, is the thing to fail.
Okay. Oh God. Well, this is.
I have to roll two then.
Yep.
Well, Shio.
Velocin, I have to do it, yeah.
Velocin, okay. And then I've got Dino number one. Saved. Dino number two.
What?
Failed. Okay. So Dino number two, everybody else. So what happens is an affected target cannot take reactions and must roll a D10 at the start of each of its turns to determine the behavior for that turn. At the end of each of its turns, an affected target can make a wisdom saving throw. If it succeeds, the effect ends. All right.
Can it go up to?
Sorry, what?
The spell, like up to a minute?
Duration.
Oh, yes, a minute.
Right.
And the rounds are 6 seconds each?
Yes. So up to possibly 10 rounds.
Okay.
All right.
You're welcome, guys.
I mean, I'm doing just fine.
Yeah.
All right. So that's that. We're going to go ahead and move on to Crow.
All right. My effect went off of it for the vulnerability. It's supposed to stay until the end of my turn. We can figure that out later.
Yeah, I could fix it in a sec.
So seeing that no one was able to smack that that one that I had passed the grave. This was what I was going to do anyway, so confusion actually worked a little bit in my favor. I was going to move here. I don't have to worry about that. But I am going to provoke an opportunity attack from Dionysus 1, Tucker.
Okay. Oh, actually, that thing fell off already by itself, so that's cool.
Yeah, it should happen at the end of my turn.
Oh, so it should stay on still.
Yep.
Okay.
So,
all
right. We can figure that out later.
So your attack of opportunity from Dionysus number two?
One.
Two.
Didn't
both?
Did two fail? Did two fail confusion?
Two did fail. So yeah, just one.
Okay.
So, okay.
Yeah.
It's gonna try to bite you.
As it should.
14.
That will actually miss.
Oh.
That worked out better than I thought.
Well, there you go.
Great. I am going to go ahead and cast a Guiding Bolt at Dionysus 1.
Okay.
Son of a bitch.
I think it misses.
It does miss.
Okay.
All right, the Bolt of Radiance shoots off in a...
Just in a direction.
In a direction.
Enter Wilhelm Scream here, kind of.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
And yeah, that's... pretty sure that's all I can do on my turn. So, yeah.
Alright.
That will be that.
Shava.
I'm just going to use my regular attack on Dionysus 2.
Okay.
Because I'm out of cool stuff at the moment.
A 13 on Dionysus 2 is enough to hit it. So roll that damage.
Damn it.
That 3 damage. Nice. Dionysus 2. Anything else, madam?
No, that's it.
Alright. Ire. Your face is a little sore, but you're good to go.
I was trying this again. And I will shoot Dionysus. The Dionysus 1 is injured. Like, it took damage, right?
It has.
Use my Colossus Slayer for extra damage. It's in. Damage.
Okay. It's 12 damage.
Oh, come on.
Anything else?
I can't see straight still.
Is that no?
Alright. Let's do. Fuck.
Alright, so you rolled a 1 on the d10 there?
Yep.
Okay. So. Your behavior is you use all of your movement in a random direction. To determine the random direction, roll a d8 and assign that direction. Okay, so we're going to start top is 1 and then all the way around is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Clockwise.
Can't wait for you to roll a 2.
Six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Bottom left corner. You can't get any further away. Oh, my God. Fuck it. I'm going to put you way over here. The dinosaur is going to attack you.
Wait,
oh,
why?
Wait, no, he's confused, too. That's right.
Yeah.
So he's not gonna what?
Ah, at least you have that going for you, which is nice.
And I'm just going to pretend that you use that, and you also use your dash to do that as well. So you're not as far away, but you don't have any actions. Go ahead and roll your wisdom check to see if you save out of it.
Nope.
Wisdom saving throw, rather. Nope, you're still confused. All right.
It looked like it was a 20, and then it rolled.
Sapphire.
All right. I am going to attack number... with the old rapier.
Okay. You definitely hit there. How much damage are you doing? 7 damage. And I'm sorry, you cut out which Deinikes? Is it 1 or 2? Can you guys hear him?
I cannot.
When I say the word 2?
Okay, there he is. Okay, 2.
Yeah.
For some reason, it just was not picking up. All right. Sick. Anything else? Seriously, so is it just everyone can't hear him, or is it just me?
I can't.
I heard it. It's kind of quiet, but.
Are you picking it up at all?
No, I'm picking you up.
I hear him.
I think maybe your single syllable answers are not enough to leave the gate open for your responses to come through.
True. Sorry. That's all that I'm doing with my turn. All
right. Perfect. Deinikes 1 is going to attack. It's going to move up 1. It's going to attack Verlassen with a claw.
Yeah.
That's a 7 on Verlassen.
It's going okay, to cool, I have 11.
It's going to attack Shava with a claw. That's a 10 on Shava. It's going to attack Catman with a bite, 14. I'm going to assume that was a no. Sapphire.
Sorry, what?
14 to hit you.
14 does hit me.
Okay.
Yes, it does.
So it does. Wait, why is it 2? It shouldn't be 2. It should just be 1. That's not how that works. What are you doing? Stop it. Bite. Okay, 7 damage. Wham. Okay. Let's see what this confused dinosaur does. It does. The creature uses its action to make a melee attack against a randomly determined creature within reach. So let's see. Oh. 1, 2, 3, 4 different options, starting with Verlassen, your 1.
Oh, please roll a 2.
It rolled a 3. So it will attack Kitty Cat. It rolled an 18, which is 5 damage to Kitty Cat.
Ow.
All right. That's use its action to make a melee attack. I guess it does all of its attacks. I'm just going to keep going.
Yeah, if it specifies it as a multi, its attack action is a multi-attack, it'll do all of it.
Okay, 18 and 7 damage to Kitty Cat.
Ow.
Why is he attacking the same one each time?
Because it says it uses its action to do a melee attack to a specific creature, to a random creature.
Well, so it has 3 melee attacks, right?
Yeah. You want me to re-roll every single time is what you're saying or suggesting?
Yeah, we should share the load. Maybe it'll attack its friend.
This is the second Lord of the Rings reference.
This is fair.
Share the load.
All right, no, it's still attacked to the kitty cat, so you're going to keep your 7 okay. damage. We're going to re-roll the last one. And then it attacks you for Lawson.
Cool.
That's a 20. And it does...
Oh, yeah, it hit me.
4 damage to you.
Okay.
Still up.
And then it is going to see if it can save out of this. And it did. It is no longer confused. For Lawson, you're up. You are confused. Roll a d10. You will attack a person randomly in a direction. All right. I don't have a d3.
Who is that? Is it a crow?
Oh, wait, d6. I do a d6 at that point in time.
That makes sense.
Six, and then just...
And I am definitely next to you.
Actually, if you right-click any of the die, you can just roll 3. Looks like.
Oh.
No, I take that back.
Oh.
Never mind.
Yeah.
I was lying. Yeah, d6. So first two would be Crow, then 3 and 4 would be Dionychus 1, and 5 and 6 would be Dionychus 2. Roll a d6, my brother. That'd be Dionychus 1. Roll that attack damage, my brother.
For my actual attack and my thing, my hammer?
Yes. It would be a melee attack. Oh, you crit. Look at that.
That's the most damage I've ever done. That's more damage I've done combined in this whole battle.
All right, go ahead and roll the damage button. I'm going to have to change some numbers here.
Oh, I already did. That's what I just rolled was damage button.
That was your attack to see if you hit him. So you had to roll the damage part, which is next to it. Or should be next to it. The 1d4 bludgeoning.
Oh, that. Okay.
Okay. So you rolled a 4. And then it's a critical. So you do maximum damage, which is 4. So that should be an 8 that you do here. So.
Yay.
Dionychus 1.
Yeah.
Almost. Not quite.
I did 8. He had 7 health. How is he not dead?
He doesn't have 7 health. That's his turn order.
Okay. Oh, the order. I'm dumb.
It's okay.
It just happens to be the same health that I have. I think. No, I still didn't math right.
No, you got 6 health.
We're gonna move on to Crow, unless you got something else up your sleeve. Oh, roll your save.
Wisdom. Right?
Yep. Nope, you're still confused.
The dinosaur manages to not be confused anymore, but we're fucked.
Crow.
Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and move to here. I'm gonna cast Word of Radiance, which is a 5-foot range, but I get to choose which creatures make the saving throw. So, obviously, the two dinosaurs need to make me a constitution.
Con saving throw.
DC 13.
13. One missed. And two saved.
Okay, so number one is going to get... Oh! 6.
Nice.
Blah. There you go.
All right. God.
Can I start eating him in my confusion?
Not you.
Turn. And I have no bonus action, so that is my turn.
Shava.
Okay, you can do the bonus action first, correct?
Yes, you can use the bonus action whenever.
So I'd like to turn into an animal, but when I look at my list of animals, they don't give me any sort of combat details. It says the module is missing.
Interesting. Hold on. Whip. Whip.
And then when I went into the library, the monster manual wasn't listed as a module that I could load.
Yeah, that was that's my fault. Hold on. Hold on here. Let me just drop there. So try to load it now.
Pretty good.
Ah, excellent.
That was my fault. Sorry, I didn't think about that.
That's okay. Give me 1 second, then I apologize.
No, it's okay. There are a lot of animal options, so.
Yes. Oh, well, this is good anyway. All right, so I'd like to turn into a lion. And then I'm going to use my... Primal Savagery, which makes my teeth and fingernails like corrosive.
All right.
Then a melee attack against one creature within 5 feet of you.
Okay. So let's see here. You do. So you roll a d20 and you get plus 5. To either your bite or claw attack, whatever you would like.
Okay.
You also get an advantage on this roll because you have pack tactics, which means you get to roll advantage if you against a creature if you have at least one ally nearby.
Oh, wonderful. All right, so just roll the d20.
Yeah, you get to roll 2 d20s, yes.
All right, so that was right click. And then just 2? Okay, yep, okay. I see.
So we'll just take the higher one there. So you rolled a 23, which will hit. So it'll be 1d8 plus 3 plus whatever your corrosive thing is.
Okay, it says 1d10 acid.
Okay, so 1d8 plus 1d10 plus 1, or plus 3. At that point in time.
Okay. What? Oh.
For acid?
Jesus Christ.
And then plus 3, so that's 9 damage there.
Probably gonna be enough.
That is enough. It certainly is. And with the green searing slashes of the lion's claws, the last dinosaur takes its final breath. And with that, the announcer goes, "Wowee! They did it! What a wonderful display of skill and prowess! Here's to our saviors!" And then the crowd goes, "You're attacking the announcer."
A direction.
Okay.
Perfect. You shoot at the announcer.
Or like just to scare, like just in his general direction to just like shut him up.
Got him, and he says, "Oh, whoa! The dinos are dead, folks. No need to be.
We got a bad boy
mean about it." And then there's like that classic like mic drop, kind of like off the stage, kind of a thing, and then you don't hear from him for a while. So.
Okay.
Anyway,
I'm gonna cast Cure Wounds on. Well, now that we're done.
Yeah.
I'll allow it.
2.
Nice. Who is that on?
Sapphire.
So, before any more spells come out, a couple things. During short rests, you can use your hit die to heal up. So hit die, each of you are level 3. Your hit die is going to be basically a dice that's determined by your class, and then you get to add your constitution modifier to it. So if you go to your main screen, down at the bottom, there's a thing that says HD. I believe if you double click that, you should be able to just roll that hit die and heal up based on that amount. And you can use up to however many you need to. And that number comes back after a long rest.
So we are going to do the full will come back and a long rest.
The what?
So we are going to have the full amount of hit die come back on our... a long rest, not half of them.
I believe correct? It'll be full, yes.
Okay.
So I rolled a so the stat is con, and then the second misc I leave blank.
It's fine the way it is. It should you shouldn't have to worry about it.